how I got this idea. It was say one of my friends who is here. I think that person will know. I've been recommending this movie to many people. This is one of my favorite movies. Not because it's really great. Let me tell you, it has some commercial elements. It has some the sentiment and the usual things also, which Indian movies are known for. But what I loved about the concept is the fact that it lays importance on that art form and makes a person who is an artist, but she refuses to take to that art because she feels that it is not glamorous. And how she gets transformed, how does she get transformed? There is, of course, a person behind here, behind every successful woman, there is a man. And the hero, whose name is Chandrasekhar, but actor Venkatesh. And of course, this was played, the dancer role was played by Bhanupriya, thankfully. And and he makes her realize, he keeps encouraging her, though there is that usual tiff between them, he keeps encouraging her. And she also happens to see the performance of foreigner, Sharon Lawrence, who is known for Odissi in real life, Odissi and Chow, and American. And then she says, for dancing, what you need is not your just bodily movements. What you need is that heart. It should come directly from here. And she gets transformed over a period of time, of course, greatly encouraged by that hero. Now, some of you, of course, remember that the climax song happened to be, of course, that was another June 2nd. 10 years ago, exactly. It happened to be the 100th post in my blog. A song which was played in the, I think during that August 15th session. And I said, I have to control my emotion because whenever I listen to that song, I lose myself. So here is the BGM, as we say, the background score, where I picked up right from the titles, and I'll keep narrating. As I go on, I'll keep narrating the behind the scenes narrative. And it's actually, now that reminds me, it's a long time during Orkut days, Bhuvana and others will remember, during Orkut days, I would pick up an album and write about the BGM, the background pieces. But later on, I stopped. Mainly, I think after switching over to FD group, I stopped that. And I would pick up a piece and write my own interpretations. But before that, I would actually relate it to the sequence. Both are, of course, fun to me, and both make sense anyway. Now, let us move on with that beautiful BGM. BGM is background score, though I prefer to call it Munnani Isai, as you people know. Munnani is forward. Okay, now let us get started with the titles. Beautiful titles with, of course, a little bit of narration by the director K. Vishwanath. It's in Telugu, but easily understandable. So I didn't want to cut those dialogues. Some of the pieces also have the dialogues. So let us first get started with the title, which is very simple music. Are you all able to hear, please? Are you all able to hear? 1 minute, let me just check the chat box. Okay, thank you. Starts like a Veda mantra, literally. Vedas don't belong to any particular religion or any particular community. Primordial sound. Let us be very clear on that. It is music.
Rallallo kuda ragalanu palikinchagala కళామూర్తులను కన్న పుణ్యభూమి మనది.
ప్రశాంత్ కరెక్ట్ మీ ఇఫ్ ఐ యామ్ రాంగ్, ఈవెన్ ఈవెన్ ఇన్ స్టోన్స్ దేర్ ఇస్ మ్యూజిక్. దట్ ఇస్ అవర్ భారతం, దట్ ఇస్ అవర్ ఇండియా.
ఈ దేశంలో ఉద్భవించిన కళలను, ఆ పరమేశ్వరుని పాదాలను అలంకరించిన స్వర్ణ కమలాలు.
స్వర్ణ కమలం ఇస్ ద గోల్డెన్ లోటస్. అగైన్ లోటస్ ఇస్ అ వెరీ వెరీ స్పిరిచువల్ ఫ్లవర్. సో లెట్ అస్ నాట్ గెట్ ఇన్ టు ఎనీ అదర్ థింగ్స్ హియర్. నో పాలిటిక్స్ ఇన్ దిస్ సెషన్, అబ్సల్యూట్లీ.
సుందర్
bell sound, just the bell sound, just listen to the bell sound, that is the calling bell also here. And there is that brush, because the hero happens to be a painter, so that brush sound. Yeah, thank you Prashant for the literal translation. Thank you very much. So very very simple title music, which just reflects the theme of the movie. Now, as I said, Bhanupriya, the heroine whose name is Meenakshi, is a reluctant dancer, and he is being introduced by the director. How she enters, she just goes to a kind of, she goes inside her house, applies makeup, okay, applies powder and all kinds of things. And her father is a dancer. I'll come to that later. He's a dancer. He's a dance teacher as well, who is blind. Later on, he gains his sight. That's fine. Now, she has an elder sister who is a musician, who is a vocalist. Now, this one, of course, during the last 2nd June, I played it, but I don't mind repeating it. This is beautifully set in a Carnatic raga, which is rare. Which is indeed rare. There is only one Tyagaraja Kriti. Somewhat technical things are needed. But what is amazing is this raga, though it is not used that much, sounds very naughty, because you just change one swara of Mohanam to something else and it becomes this raga. Okay, just listen to this beautiful piece. It starts something like Shankaravarnam and then goes. Just sound. The percussion sounds naughty because she is very, very playful. This is a raga called Nagaswarani. There is only one Kriti of Tyagaraja, which is Sripate, and it's a pentatonic raga. And you change the, in place of Re in Mohanam, you put replace it with Ma, and that is this raga. But sounds very very different.
Meena.
Okay, so she is called. So beautiful thinking. And now, when the dancer is introduced that way, how will the musician be introduced? Savitri, who is her elder sister. He is being introduced like this with a song. Let's listen to that short piece.
Atma tvam girija mati sahachara prana shari. Shri Narayana.
him Chakravagam. So this is how she, of course, that is not introduction, but just to show that she's a musician. And my musician son says that there is one more Kriti of Tyagaraja. Are you sure? Okay, then leave it. Now, as I said, this Meenakshi looks for glamour and she keeps talking to her sister, what is this Kuchipudi? And now you will be singing Sarigamapa. What kind of life is this? And she goes to sleep. And it's a kind of surrealistic scene where they're all the three, that is father, the two daughters are traveling in a kind of bullock cart. And this gentleman plays a beautiful Tyagaraja Kriti, which is Chakkani Raja Margamu Undaka, which means that when you have that royal path, why do you look for lanes and bylanes? Why do you look for that? And it goes on. Just listen to this beautiful piece. Actually, K. Vishwanath Garu is known for suggesting to music directors about playing Tyagaraja Kriti. Actually, he did a lot for Shankarabharanam to K. V. Mahadevan. And if you people remember one of my old posts of Sagara Sangamam, he played, Ilaraja played that Malavi Kriti. Viraj, what is that Malavi Kriti? When Kamal and Jayaprada meet, Nenarunchina. That is why you need to have some assistance now and then. Because I had two involved. Now, I'm not sure whether Vishwanath Garu suggested or Raja Sir himself did it, but beautiful Chakkani Raja for some time, and then it goes to something else also. Listen to this piece. Starts with a kind of poignant music in Sarangi because that Meenakshi is dreaming. Oh God, what kind of life is this? She goes to sleep. This Kriti itself has about, the first line itself has about 22 Sangatis. That is, the musician keeps on singing in different Sangatis. Sangatis are variations. And my father-in-law actually used to say this quite often. That is, how Tyagaraja, why Tyagaraja is brilliant? He is composed it like, Chakkani Raja. It's going so royal. And then for the bylane, it goes, it just goes like this. It goes like devious. Just sing that. Second line. Just see this for a minute. Just to show the grandeur of this Kriti and how it has been used, why it has been used.
Chakkani Raja Margamu Undaka, Chakkani Raja Margamu Undaka, Chakkani Raja Margamu Undaka, Sandula Dura Nela Omanasa.
Thank you very much. So, of course, he sang only three Sangatis. Actually, it has about 22 Sangatis. All those Sangatis will show that royal thing. That is, you have such a beautiful Chakkani is beautiful. Chakkani is what? Beautiful, right? Prashant? Chakkani. Chakkani Raja Margamu Undaka. You have that royal path. Why do you choose lanes and bylanes there? It goes like this. Why do you go like that? And all the sangatis, the first line will have that royal effect. That is Tyagaraja. Now this is Ilayaraja for you. Just listen.
Prapanchamanta chakchaka ala mundiki sagipothu unte inka ela manam venakapadunnamo
ditta dilita ketta.
She is saying that every world is so advanced, but we are still backward, and is our father is doing the nadvanga. It's all in her dreams.
కథ దిగులతో దిత్తా దిమిత కథ కథలాంకుత దిమిత కథ దిగులతో
మన తోటి వాళ్ళంతా బిఏలు ఎంఏలు చదువుకుని హాయిగా జీవితం గడిపేస్తుంటే మనమే ఉంటే కూపస్ మండుకాల్లా.
They have all studied here in MA and have reached high levels. What are we doing? And then our sister sings, Niti Chala Sukama. Is money more important? This was sung by Tyagaraja in a very different situation. Let us not get too much into that. Just listen to this.
Sukama Ramuni Sannidhi Seva Sukama
Nana, ee kalane namukuni jeevithani dharapostunnavu kada, tirigi kala neekem ichindi nana?
Ee kalalanni ee kalalone mokshanni prasadinchi.
What have you achieved? She is asking her dad, what have you achieved with this art form? And the daughter is replying that this leads to salvation.
పొందుతో కైలాసం అంటారు ఇదే కాబోలు.
వెరీ ఫేమస్ కృతి ఆఫ్ మైసూర్ వాసుదేవాచార్య ఇన్ కమాజ్ విచ్ కమ్స్ ఇన్ విచ్ అపియర్స్ ఇన్ శంకరాభరణం ఆల్సో శంకరాభరణం మూవీ. And it says, don't you have some compassion towards me? See, oh Rama. So it's being used in this situation. Now, I told you how naughty this Meenakshi is. What she does is to avoid this dance classes, she decides to throw her ankle bells into the bell, and that's only music. Just listen to the music. You can just visualize what happened. Just listen to this music. She goes and throws. Listen to the naughtiness in that violin. It's almost sounding like, ayyo, ayyo, why are you doing this? Ayyo, why are you doing this? And then the hero goes and retrieves that. That's different. I have not taken that piece. Now, there is a very, very interesting sequence, which also happens to be one of my most favorites. What happens is, I told you about this elder sister. He was a musician. And there is a neighbor. And his father is a guard in railways or an engine driver, I'm not sure. I think he's a guard. And so they are poor. This person is always into music, plays violin in Western classical style. Now, this father gets to know about that love. That is, he and this first daughter are in love with each other. I'm not seeing any chat messages now. Please excuse me because I'm in the flow now. I will see it later. Now, what happens is, so is that father says, hey, what do you have? You're not even earning. And you want to get married to her who sells puppets. You want to get married to her. What asset do you have? So this person just goes, takes his violin, and he plays it to this Savitri's father. A beautiful piece in Western classical. Mesmerizing scene indeed.
Savitri, ఒకసారి ఇలా రండి. రండి.
So he's calling her. He's going to her house and calling her.
సార్
ఏమిటయ్యా ఇది ఎంత పెద్ద నమస్కారం చేస్తున్నావు
చెప్తానండి నేను సావిత్రి ఒకరంటే ఒకరు ఇష్టపడుతున్నా
హి ఇస్ టెల్లింగ్ us her father that we are in love with each other
పెళ్లి కూడా చేసుకోవాలనుకుంటున్నా
అండ్ ఐ వాంట్ టు గెట్ మ్యారీడ్
నాకున్న ఆస్తి అర్హత ఇదొక్కటే
దిస్ ఇస్ మై ఓన్లీ అసెట్ అండ్ హి స్టార్ట్స్ ప్లేయింగ్ So he's saying in between, of course, there are a lot of technical things. There was the chromatism and also that pizzicato, where that only that this one was plucked. And then a father is saying, now go and ask Savitri if she's in love really. She wants to get married.
Nanchi pin vinnauga. అతనికి ఉన్న ఆస్తల్లా సంగీతం ఒకటే మరి నీకు ఇష్టం లేకపోతే ఇప్పుడే చెప్పేయి
సో షీ ఇస్ ఆస్కింగ్ ద యంగర్ సిస్టర్ మీనాక్షి ఇస్ ఆస్కింగ్ నౌ డిడ్ యు హియర్ దట్ ఆర్ నాట్ ఇస్ ఓన్లీ అసెట్ ఇస్ మ్యూజిక్ అండ్ దిస్ ఇస్ ద రిప్లై గివెన్ బై ద ఎల్డర్ వన్
నాకున్న ఆభరణం కూడా ఒక సంగీతమే
ది ఆర్నమెంట్ ఐ హావ్ ద ఓన్లీ ఆర్నమెంట్ ఐ హావ్ ఇస్ మ్యూజిక్ ఐ థింక్ పీపుల్ హూ ఆర్ totally immersed in fine arts will surely get goosebumps if this when they watch the scene or when they even listen to this now a father who is blind he gets back his eyesight and this Venkatesh Chandrasekhar paints Bhanupriya in a banner because he paints he's a painter in a dancing pose and they see that painting look at the music now
chusara sir meenakshi garni adigondi akkada
there's a small boy who is his assistant Venkatesh assistant and he says did you see meenakshi she's there and a beautiful piece in Mayamala Gola
Aame nahi
aun sir sakshatu meenakshi gare movala savadu chupistannaga chusara andamaina amma evaru cheppandi chaala baagundi kadate appude anta paisajjamo nu ankandi inka chaala unnai rendi rendi
He says there are more, many more. Come and see. Okay, this is that piece. And now, what happens is this elder one gets married, and Chandrasekhar, that is Venkatesh, arranges for a performance of Meenakshi, that is Bhanupriya, without her consent. And she is very upset, and somehow she wants to insult. So what she does is she goes on stage. What she had already cut that ankle bells and she just throws it to the audience and goes boxer the maximum insult possible and listen to that. And immediately after that, a father starts dancing because he's a dancer. But here I have my own views because he could have actually chosen a better dancer, whatever it is. And he does in Pancha Nadai, in all the five nadais, and he dies. So this whole piece is that. Listen to this. There is commotion in the audience because she just throws her ankle bells and walks. So he takes up and dances. Down on stage and dies.
Nana.
Violin, and that's about it. Now he meets, Venkatesh goes and meets Bhanupriya after that, and this is what happens. It rains heavily there. It plays in sitar. Now she again says, she says, why are you interfering in my life, please? Because of you I lost my father. And then she goes home, and now Venkatesh is dreaming. What happens is, this is just before a song, which is set in Valachi Ragam. So here, just to give the prelude, even before the song starts, Raja sir shifts to Valachi. Shiva Pujaku song, which I might write later. I might write about that later. Now, this elder daughter and that violinist get married. There is a beautiful interaction between them. She bathes him, that is, she gives head massage, and he's sitting near the well. And she's singing in Ananda Bhairavi. And this person responds in Western style in Ananda Bhairavi. It's a very beautiful scene there.
ದೇವರಾಜ ಸೇವ್ಯಮಾನ ಪಾವನ ಪಾವನ ತ್ರಿಪಂಕಜಂ
ಆಹಾ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಸಂಗೀತ ನೇರ್ಚುಕುನಾ ಮನ ಸಂಗೀತ ಕೂಡ ಎಲ್ಲ ವಾಯಿಸ್ತುಂದು ಚೂಡು
ಸರ್ಲೇಂಡಿ
If I learn Western music, see, I'm able to play Indian classical also. Listen to that Western style. Actually, this is sung by Shailaja, of course, in recording room. Now, what happens is, violin doesn't really play Ananda Bhairavi, because Ananda Bhairavi is not a scale based raga, it's a gamaka based raga. But here it goes in Western style, just playing the notes, simple notes.
Vanditam Digambaram.
There's a kind of banter between them.
Is that correct? Why is that?
It's a beautiful scene. Now, what happens is we go to the main heroine again, where for the first time she realizes after that foreign dancer tells her that art has to come from here and not just your bodily movements. First time she realizes, and this is that music when she gets that realization. If you remember my post also, one of the posts revolved around realization. English post. She's actually wearing that anklet, wearing it. She's picking it with so much of devotion like she had never done before, and she's doing it. And look at the music. As if it's bubbling. And then the final realization after that marvelous song called Andala Ravamidi, which I wrote exactly 10 years ago, being the 100th post in my blog, where I wrote about Saiva Siddhanta also. Some of you might remember. Now, after that song, she feels ashamed and she's running. And there's only percussion there. She feels ashamed that she was after glamour all this while. Oh. that romantic Raja, how can one forget him? Now, almost each and every movie of his has that leitmotif, which runs as the undercurrent. He takes a theme for some characters of our situations and keeps repeating, but he'll give variations. And most of the times, it will be probably based on the same raga as one of the songs in the movie, but it'll be a kind of variant. But here, the romantic sequence between Bhanupriya and Venkatesh, Meenakshi and Chandrasekhar, he chose Pahadi, which is not even, none of the songs in the movie is in Pahadi. And so much of variation. Now, this is the first Pahadi. Rather, it's just the percussion where Venkatesh sees Bhanupriya for the first time. Something like a folksy tune, of course, flute bass. Subhashini, you won't forget this, right? You remember Geetanjali? I played it and immediately you answered that. Not this piece, one of the pieces. Now, this is the second Pahadi where he sees that, well, they meet. They really meet, literally meet. And she lies to her family that she goes to a hospital, but she goes to a movie hall. And she loses her bag. Now, Venkatesh picks up the bag and gives that back. On the road.
ఈ బ్యాగ్ మీదే కదండి ఆహా చూడండి మీరు
మీనాక్షి
ఆహా మీరు మధ్యాహ్నం కూడా హాస్పిటల్ వెళ్ళక్కర్లేదు మీనాక్షి గారు ఈ రోజంతా ప్రింట్ వచ్చేట్లేదు రేపు 9 గంటల ఆటకు వెళ్తే చాలు ఏమండి ఇదిగో
జస్ట్ ద గిటార్ అండ్ ద బేస్ బిహైండ్ దట్ అండ్ దెన్ ద ఫ్లూట్ is bringing that variation. She is going and Venkatesh is looking at her. Look at that variation now. Okay, now this is Pahadi number 3. Subhashini, your favorite. This is Pahadi number 4. Look at the variations. Each and every melody is different.
Good morning. Congratulations. Chala smart ga unnaru.
What happens here is that she gets a job in a hotel, 5-star hotel in Vizag. And because she wants to chase that glamour. So, she's going to work for the first time. And Venkatesh sees her. Again, this part, he's saying, you're looking beautiful. But look at the variations in each and every Pahadi.
Auto. Auto. Amagaran jarte diskut. Alage sir.
This entire piece doesn't have any percussion. It just goes, flows like, shall I say Godavari? I don't want to say Kaveri. Godavari. Now this is Pahadi number 5. this is in the climax. This is during the climax. We have reached the climax where she realizes the true value of dance and that Sharon Laurel, right? Laurel, okay. American dancer takes her to America to dance. And here is where I differ from the director. Anyway, it's the usual Indian cinema where somebody fights for, somebody motivates her, but again, he longs for her. And so she's caught in 2 minds. That is when she realizes her love for him, while hero has been in love right from the beginning. Now, climax, she's caught in 2 minds. It goes, I think it runs for only 15 minutes with breaks, but each and every break, there is some superb music. She's the airport, Vizag Airport. And first is a piece in Natai. Just listen to this. There is some dialogue and then it continues. Second note. We can even call it Chalanatai. Now, there is a song called Kottaga, Rekkarechina. And that is sung after that first realization is made. So now he sends a letter, hero sends a letter to her in the airport that expressing himself in a very, very cryptic way. So the tune of that song is played here. And then this climax where again Dharmavati plays a role because the climax song is also
her boarding card.
And then there is that music. It is just music. Next 4.5 minutes, just music in the movie. If I think one of the shows somebody showed, I think it was Balki who showed that how that scene is without music and with music. Of course, they had actually muted the dialogues as well. So without music, if one imagines that scene, it would have been nothing. This is the climax where the heroine runs towards the hero who is just busy painting. A piece which runs for 4.5 minutes and it has the pahadi also. So listen to this and then we wind up. Actually from Dharmavati, Rajasa suddenly shifts to Madhuvanti here in Chennai because she's very sad. She's just in the process of going towards him from the airport. Thank you.
ఒకవేళ మీ ఖాళీ మువ్వల సబ్బడిలో నా గుండె చప్పుడు వినిపిస్తే మరోలా అనుకోకండే, మన ఈ చిన్ని స్నేహాన్ని మర్చిపోలేని మీ చంద్రశేఖర్. మీ చంద్రశేఖర్. మీ చంద్రశేఖర్.
Just the sound of the waves in Vizag, and the person who respects nature and silence just leaves it blank that time. Just listen to the waves. Sounds so romantic. And he shifts to Valachi and they play that Valachi song at the end. That completes Swarna Kamalam, one of Raja's. Unfortunately, this movie was released in 1988, the same year when Rudra Veena was released. So, award for music went for Rudra Veena. Maybe they could have given two awards, one for this, one for that. Unforgettable. And I actually see the chat messages. Today, I was totally in a different zone because this movie has impacted me so much, and I took nearly 2 days to rip. I had already downloaded the movie, but only the audio. I wanted to listen to the audio to fine-tune my Telugu also. And then I ripped. And that's about it. So now I wait for your feedback, if there is.